السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا. من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له. وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما. أما بعد، فإن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله وخير الهدي هدي نبينا محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم وشر الأمور محدثاتها وكل محدثة بدعة وكل بدعة ضلالة وكل ضلالة في النار. طيب، let's start our topic. Chapter 19, Kitab Tauhid. Chapter 19, Kitab Tauhid, page 78. قال الشيخ محمد بن عبد الوهاب رحمه الله تعالى: Excessive dogma in the righteous persons is the root cause of identity of mankind and its deviation from true religion. باب ما جاء أن الغلو في الصالحين. باب ما جاء. باب ما جاء أن سبب كفر بني آدم وتركهم دينهم هو الغلو في الصالحين. This is very important chapter. Okay. Now there is a question. Why do people commit the shirk? We are Muslims. We say La ilaha illallah. We know Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And we pray, we fast, we give zakah. But now the question comes to many Muslims. Why do people commit shirk? So Sheikh rahimahullah said, he said, السبب, he mentioned السبب, the cause is الغلو في الصالحين. الغلو في الصالحين. Okay, اللي هو excessive of praising. More respecting the pious people more than enough. Exceeding the limits. Because what is the meaning of الغلو? الغلو. This is the Arabic word. الغلو means to exceed the limits. Okay? يعني for example, the same thing, الطغيان. الطغيان. الطغيان also to exceed the limit. As Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, إنا لما طغى الماء, about the people of Nuh, about the story of Nuh عليه الصلاة والسلام, Allah mentioned, إنا لما طغى الماء. What's mean طغى الماء? Okay, it means the water exceeded the level, the normal level. You know, in the sea there is a normal level. Okay, but subhanAllah, if the sea exceeds the normal level, the water will cover the land. And this happened at the time of Nuh alayhi salatu wasalam. And the same thing, الغلو. الغلو to exceed the limit. And this is haram, الغلو. بما جاء أن سبب كفر بني آدم. Why they are kuffar? Why some of the people disbelieved in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? Why some of the Muslims, some of the Muslims left Islam. They disbelieved in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala after Islam. Okay, so there is an important point, brothers and sisters. Can we say that there are Muslims who became kuffar? Yes. Yes. As Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in the Quran, in Surah At-Tawbah, if you remember, we mentioned that. لا تعتذروا قد كفرتم بعد إيمانكم. And this chapter will come about mocking the Islam, الاستهزاء في الدين, mocking the religion. Allah says clearly in Surah Tawbah, قد كفرتم بعد إيمانكم. You disbelieved after your faith, after your Iman, after your Islam. So there is a concept of in Islam is called الردّة. الردة. What does it mean for ردة? ردة, for example, you are walking this street, or you are driving. Then يرتد, you come back. So this is your way, Islam. Then after Islam, you return back to كفر والعياذ بالله. This is called الردة. And no doubt, this is one of the rules clear in Islam, as the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, من بدل دينه فاقتلوه. The one who changed his religion, we should kill him. And the other hadith, لا يحل دم المسلم إلا بإحدى ثلاث. النفس بالنفس والتارك لدينه, النفس بالنفس والثيب الزاني والتارك لدينه المفارق للجماعة. Shedding blood is not allowed except three cases. النفس بالنفس, القصاص means if someone killed another person, this person should be killed. والثيب الزاني, if a married person did adultery, والعياذ بالله. Number three, التارك لدين المفارق الجماعة, the one who left his religion. Of course, please, brothers, sisters, this rule, I mean this rule for these three types of people, not for us to apply the killing. This is the responsibility of the ruler, of the government, of the court. We should not, it is not allowed for any one of us, I mean from the general public people, to decide this person should be killed. No, this is not Islam. This should be through the court. Okay, the judge will decide that this person should be killed. So please, brothers and sisters, don't go and read the hadith and you try to apply the hadith by your own self. No, there are rules, should be done only by the court, not by the general people, not by the public. Because imagine, if I see a person who's committing zina, then I go and I kill him. Then they ask me, oh Ahmed, why did you kill this person and this lady, this man and this lady? Because I saw them doing zina. Okay? Maybe they were not doing zina. Maybe husband and wife. Maybe they were in a car together, but they are not doing adultery. Okay? Yani, Islam wants to protect the community. Islam doesn't agree with al-fawda, with the mess. No. Islam wants to keep the Muslim community very well organized. And this is very important, that these decisions should be done by the authority. Okay, maybe some people say, but they are not doing that in our courts. They are not doing that. It will take long time. This process takes maybe 2-3 months. So let me do it now and we finish. No. If every person kills the people who are doing fornication and the one who's left Islam, it will be a big mess. Maybe because I have a financial problem. Maybe he took my money. Okay, so I kill him and I claim because he said kufr. He said the word of kufr. Subhanallah. So please, brothers, sisters, yes, we have rules in Islam like that. Yes, but these rules should be applied by the government, by the authority.
by the ruler, by the judge, not by everyone. Why? This is to protect the community. طيب. So the point is that some Muslims will leave Islam. And this is one of the important concepts, or one of the important points, because sometimes you hear some da'iya or some Muslim say, alhamdulillah, alhamdulillah, don't speak about kufr. Why you are talking about shirk? Why you are talking about the graves? Alhamdulillah, we are Muslims, we say la ilaha illallah. We should do our best to give da'wah for the non-Muslims. Khalas, why you are talking about the Muslims? Habibi, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said that shirk will come again. لا تقوم الساعة حتى تطلب أليات نساء دوس حول ذي الخلصة. سبحان الله. The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم mentioned that the day of judgment will not start until the ladies of دوس. Okay, they will do طواف. They will go around ذي الخلصة, one of the idols. سبحان الله. It means the shirk will come again to the Arab world. It means some of the Muslims will leave Islam. So this is there. So please, brothers and sisters, don't try to deny something. You cannot deny the fact. Yani now there is sun, it is day. You say, no, it is night. You cannot, and you should not. So like many people, no, we don't have shirk. Why you are speaking about shirk? I remember one time I was talking with my colleague, and he said, why you are talking about shirk? He doesn't like the Salafi people. He doesn't like Muhammad Abdul Wahhab. He's against, subhanallah, totally against Muhammad Abdul Wahhab. And he said that Muhammad Abdul Wahhab did a mischief in the world, and he killed the Muslims, and because of him we have ISIS. I told my friend, please bring me a proof. Maybe from last year I told him, bring me a proof from the books of Muhammad Abdul Wahhab. His books I don't claim that Muhammad Abdul Wahhab is a messenger, is a prophet. No, he's a human being. He has mistakes, no doubt. I have mistakes, you have mistakes. All of us has mistakes. But to claim that Muhammad Abdul Wahhab told people to kill the Muslims, and ISIS came because of Muhammad Abdul Wahhab, they are students of Muhammad Abdul Wahhab. So I told him, okay, give me the proof. Let me check. Maybe I agree with you. If you bring me a proof, okay, and this is authentic, I will agree with you. Then I will say Muhammad Abdul Wahhab did that. But just to claim Muhammad Abdul Wahhab is a bad man, Muhammad Abdul Wahhab is a shaytan. Allah astaghfirullah al-azim. They say Muhammad Abdul Wahhab is shaytan. Why is shaytan? Okay, bring the proof. Subhanallah. So, yes, this friend or this colleague said at work, he said, why are you saying shirk, shirk, shirk? Where is shirk? Alhamdulillah, we are Muslims. I told him, yani, if you did not see the shirk, we saw the shirk. We saw the people going around the graves. We heard people saying, calling other than Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. They call Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, oh Muhammad. This is shirk. As Muslims, we should call Allah. We should say, oh Allah, ya Allah. Brothers, sisters, we as Muslims, what do we say in our dua? Allahumma ghfir lana, Allahumma arhamna, Allahumma tub alayna, in the witr, in the sujood, okay, or any time. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But we as Muslims, we don't ask Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. What can he do for us? Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, yes, no doubt, he is the best. Alayhi salatu wasalam, the best man. But he cannot do anything for us now. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to accept his intercession for us. We ask Allah, not Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, as we explained before 2 weeks and 3 weeks. So this brother is denying, no shirk, don't speak, no need to speak about shirk. No, we have to speak about shirk. We have to. Okay, when the Prophet ﷺ mentioned the ahadith about shirk during the time of the companions. So can you go and you tell the Prophet ﷺ, oh Muhammad, don't speak about shirk because you have companions with you? The Prophet ﷺ mentioned brothers, sisters, we have to know what is good and what is bad. We have to know the good to do it, and we have to know the bad to avoid it. So what made people to disbelieve in Allah? Al-ghulu fi al-salihin. Sheikh rahimahullah said this is the cause. Okay, but of course there are many things. There are many things lead to kufr, lead to the disbelief, as we mentioned in the tafsir. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned in Surah Al-Baqarah, illa iblis aba wa istakbara wa kana min al-kafirin. Why did not Iblis fall in prostration for Adam? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told us this is because of kibr, arrogance. Why did not the Yahud believe in Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam? Because of hasad, because of envy. So some people disbelieve because of envy, because of arrogance, because of exceeding the limits with the righteous people. There are many reasons, but the main thing, or one of the main points, this one. Okay. Then he mentioned the ayah. We are in chapter 19, page 78. يا أهل الكتاب لا تغلوا في دينكم ولا تقولوا على الله إلا الحق. O people of the scripture, it means Jews and Christians, don't exceed the limits in your religion, nor say of Allah anything but the truth. Sheikh, this is about the Yahud and Nasara, Jews and Christians. Why you are telling us an ayah about the Jews and Christians? Because also it is related for us. If Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told the Jews and Christians don't do that, it means also for us. We should not do the same. يَا أَهْلَ الْكِتَابِ لَا تَغْلُوا فِي دِينِكُمْ. Don't exceed the limits in your religion. So the Christians and Nasara, they exceeded the limit in their religion. How? They raised Isa alayhi salatu wasalam, the Prophet Isa. They raised him more than his level. Of course, the level of Isa is very high alayhi salatu wasalam. We have to believe that Isa is a prophet, that Isa is a messenger, that Isa is one of the best alayhi salatu wasalam. Okay, yani as Sheikh Muhtamin rahimahullah mentioned that the best five people: Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam, Ibrahim, Musa, Isa, and Nuh. He mentioned that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam, Muhammad is the best, then Ibrahim, then Musa, then Isa or Nuh. So he is one of the best alayhi salatu wasalam. So no doubt his level is very high. But we should not jump beyond his level. It means we should not put Isa alayhi salatu wasalam in a level like Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He is a human being and he is not a God alayhi salatu wasalam. So they said that Isa ibn Allah. They said that Isa thalithu thalatha. From where this information? From where this information? From the Quran. Allah says, لَقَدْ كَفَرَ الَّذِينَ قَالُوا إِنَّ اللَّهَ ثَالِثُ ثَلَاثَةَ لَقَدْ كَفَرَ الَّذِينَ قَالُوا إِنَّ اللَّهَ هُوَ الْمَسِيحُ بْنُ مَرْيَمُ. Okay? Those who said that Allah is out of three, means Isa, Allah, and Maryam, or Isa, Allah, and Ruh al-Qudus, they are kuffar. And also those who said that Isa is Allah, also they are kuffar. So this is the meaning of exceeding the limit. And about the Yahud, Allah said, subhanahu wa ta'ala, and also some of them said that Isa is the son of Allah. in Surah At-Tawbah. وقالت النصارى المسيح ابن الله. وقالت اليهود عزير ابن الله. وقالت النصارى المسيح ابن الله. So the Jews exceeded the limit with عزير. Who's عزير? الله أعلم exactly. Okay, some scholars said عزير is a pious man, a righteous man. So they worshipped عزير. I mean the Jews. So they exceeded the limit with عزير. And the Nasara with Isa عليه الصلاة والسلام. Okay, so Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, يَا أَهْلَ الْكِتَابِ لَا تَغْلُوا فِي دِينِكُمْ. So all people of the scripture, don't exceed the limits in your religion. So this is a rule from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is very important, brothers and sisters. لَا تَغْلُوا فِي دِينِكُمْ. Okay, Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is a prophet. Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is a messenger. Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is the best man. Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is the most person who is kind, alayhi salatu wa sallam. But when we say Muhammad knows the unseen, no, you have to stop. There were some girls saying that وَفِينَ نَبِيُّ وَفِينَ نَبِيٌ يَعْلَمْ مَا فِي غَدِي. And a person who is among us knows what is happening tomorrow. The Prophet said, no, stop. Don't say that. It's not allowed. Yes, you respect me. You say, Wallah, I am your prophet. I am your messenger. I am. Okay. But to say that I know the unseen, I know the future, this is not acceptable. So the Prophet stopped them. These girls, they were singing. Okay. Of course, when I say they were singing, it doesn't mean music. Saying a poem, شعر. طيب. The main thing here in this chapter, the explanation from Ibn Abbas. In Bukhari mentioned about the ayah. وقالوا لا تذرن آلهتكم ولا تذرن ودا ولا سواعا ولا يغوث ويعوق ونسرا. And they have said, you shall not leave your gods, nor shall you leave Wad, nor Suwa, nor Yaghuth, nor Ya'uq and Nasr. طيب, what are these? Abdullah ibn Abbas radiallahu ta'ala said, these are the names of some righteous persons from Nuh's people. When they passed away, okay, يعني many scholars said they were before Nuh عليه الصلاة والسلام, يعني before, يعني from the city of Nuh عليه الصلاة والسلام, from the village of Nuh, before Nuh became a prophet. They were five people, pious people, righteous people. ود وسواع ويغوث ونسر. طيب, when they passed away, okay, Shaitan inspired their people to set up statues in their honor and set them in their gathering places, and to give these statues the names of those departed. Subhanallah, the Shaitan whispered to them. The Shaitan informed them. Exactly how Allah alam, maybe he came in a shape of a human being, he was whispering to them. Okay, so he told them, they are pious people, so how come you forget them just when they passed away? Do something to remember them. Do idols, do statues, because when you see Yaghuth, this is the shape of Yaghuth. I remember Yaghuth was a very generous man. Then I will give charity. When I see Nasra, okay, he was a good reciter of Quran or their book. So I'll go and I read. The third one was fasting. So when I see him, I remember fasting. The fourth one. So when you see them, you will remember the righteous deeds and you will imitate them in the good things. So they did. Why did they build the idols? Okay, not to worship them, just to remember. Just to remember the good people. So they did that. And they gave these names. This statue with the name of Yaghuth and this Nasr, the same names, five. وَسَمَّوْهَا بِأَسْمَائِهِمْ وَلَمْ تُعْبَدْ. This is, brothers, sisters, this is very important. Abdullah ibn Abbas said, they did this, but did not worship them. So they built the statues, but they did not worship them. They know these are just stones or wood or mud, whatever. They cannot do anything for us. We put them just to remember them and to remember their deeds. This is very important. Okay? Then Abdullah ibn Abbas said, until these people passed away. What is the meaning until these people? It means the generation and the friends of the five righteous people. Also, they passed away. And knowledge. And تَنَسَّخَ الْعِلْمِ. Also, people forgot their knowledge. It means they ignored knowledge. It means ignorance. SubhanAllah. And knowledge of their origins were forgotten. The next generation, or after the next generation, when they came, they saw these idols, they saw these pictures, but they did not know why our fathers or our grandfathers put these statues. They don't have knowledge. Then they were worshipped. So Abdullah ibn Abbas said, they were worshipped after the first generation. SubhanAllah. So this is very important, brothers and sisters. That's why the Salaf, the scholars of the Salaf, emphasize teaching the Tauhid, learning the Tauhid, learning the Shirk, teaching the Shirk. This is very important. This is, brothers and sisters, this is the most important thing. Suppose that you are will experience in the da'wah. You are, mashallah, perfect in your talks. You are clever and smart in answering all the complicated questions about the financial problems, about the zakah, about the inheritance. Also, you can answer about the salah, zakah, hajj, about the husband-wife relationship, but you don't have the knowledge of Tawheed. You don't know the danger of Shirk. Then you are not a good Muslim. You are not a good scholar. You have to study. Who is the good scholar? The one who knows the Tawheed, who knows the Shirk, teaching the Tawheed, teaching the Shirk. And also, we have to know the Tawheed in details and also the Shirk in details. This is very important, brothers and sisters. We have to know the details of the Tawheed, the names of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the Tawheed al-Rububiyyah, the Lordship of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Tawheed al-Uluhiyyah, to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala alone. This is very important. And this is important not only to discuss the others and to say you are Mubtadi and you are Ash'ari and you are Quburi. This is very important for your faith. If you know Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, then you will taste the iman. If you know the real tawheed, you will taste the fruit of tawheed, of Islam. This is very important, brothers and sisters. And who cares about the tawheed? And who cares about teaching people the shirk, to avoid the shirk? Only the Salafi scholars. Subhanallah. Only the Salafi scholars. Yeah, for example, read the books of Sheikh bin Uthaymeen, rahimahullah, one of the great Salafi scholars. Or for example, listen to the fatwa of Sheikh bin Baz, rahimahullah. Okay, I mean, our Salafi scholars, they speak about the Tawheed. And they warn people from the shirk. While the other sects don't care about that. Yes, they speak about the Tawheed, but general. They speak about shirk, but general. Subhanallah. So, this is very important. Ibn al-Qayyim, rahimahullah, said after that. Ibn al-Qayyim, rahimahullah, said. Who is Ibn al-Qayyim? Ibn al-Qayyim is the most famous student of Ibn Taymiyyah. And no need to tell you who is Ibn Taymiyyah, rahimahullah ta'ala. Okay, Ibn Taymiyyah, of course, he is the great scholar. Okay, Ahmad ibn Abd al-Halim, ibn Abd al-Salam, ibn Abdullah, ibn Taymiyyah, al-Dimashqi al-Harrani. Or al-Harrani al-Dimashqi. Abu al-Abbas. When we say Shaykh al-Islam, ibn Taymiyyah. Okay, he has great students. Okay, yeah, and one of the points that how can you know or the sign that this is a great scholar if you see great school students for him. Yeah, for example, if you see good students. Okay, I think the teachers know what I'm saying now. Okay, maybe there are teachers who are listening to my lecture now. Okay, if you, for example, if you teach students. Okay, yeah, for example, brothers, okay, one of them in grade 5, the other in grade 7. And maybe before 10 years also you taught the eldest brother. So maybe you taught 3 or 4 brothers. You notice, mashallah, all of them polite. Okay, then you are sure that the parents are polite. Okay, so Sheikh al-Islam Taymiyyah, the great scholar, okay, the most famous student for him, Ibn al-Qayyim, rahimahullah. Ibn al-Qayyim, Muhammad ibn Abi Bakr al-Zar'i al-Dimashqi. Okay, he passed away, rahimahullah, 751. And Sheikh al-Islam Taymiyyah passed away 728. Also, one of the famous students of Sheikh al-Islam Ibn Taymiyyah, Ibn Miflih al-Hanbali, Muhammad ibn Miflih al-Hanbali, also Ibn Abd al-Hadi, also al-Hafiz al-Mizzi, yani, these are great scholars. Ibn Kathir, the scholar of the Tafsir, scholar of the Tafsir also. طيب, Ibn al-Qayyim said, rahimahullah ta'ala, that most of our predecessors have stated, after the death of the righteous persons, they confined at their graves and made statues. And after much time passed, they started worship them. Subhanallah. So, what did lead to the shirk? When they exceeded the limits in respecting and praising these righteous people. Okay. We respect the scholars. We have to respect the scholars. We should love our scholars. And after their death, okay, we make dua for them. For example, Sheikh bin Baz, we make dua, Sheikh bin Baz. Allahumma arham, Allahumma aghfir, Sheikh bin Uthaymeen, Sheikh al-Albani, bin Taymiyyah. Okay, we make dua for them. And this is the sign of love. Okay, but what was the problem? They said the problem, because they loved them, but they expressed their love in a wrong way. How? They went to their graves. and they were sitting around their graves. Then after time, maybe they built something on their graves, and also they built statues. Okay, so subhanAllah, now the same thing is again. Some people go, some people, because they respect the Sheikh. This is our Sheikh. We love him. We should respect him. How? We should make his grave in a different way. No, this is haram. The grave should be simple. Not more than one hand span. Just maybe 20 or 30 centimeters, the height. Because the Prophet ﷺ said to Ali, أَلَّا تَدْعَ قَبْرًا مُشْرِفًا إِلَّا سَوَّيْتَ. Don't let any high grave until you make it straight. Okay, the scholar said, what does the meaning of straight? It means just one shibran, one hand span. Yeah, about 20 or 30 centimeters. Okay, so this is hadith by Ali radiallahu ta'ala an. So they were going there, and they think when we sit there, it means we are expressing our love. And with time, maybe they start to make dua. Yeah, for example, now I have an exam tomorrow. So I'm doing dua now. Allahumma sahhal alayhi imtihan. Allahumma aftah alayhi fil imtihan. I have an exam tomorrow, so I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make the exam easy. But because of the shaitan, why are you doing dua here at home? No, Ahmed, go to the graveyard and find where is the grave of your sheikh. And go there and ask Allah there. Why? This is the sign that, the sign of your love to your toward your sheikh. And this is haram. I will not say this is shirk, but this can lead to shirk, and this will come inshallah in the next chapter. Tayyib. In the next ayah, sorry, in the next proof, hadith, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, لا تطروني كما أطرت النصارى ابن مريم إنما أنا عبد فقولوا عبد الله ورسوله. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said in the authentic hadith, don't exaggerate in praise of me, just as the Christians exaggerated in the praise of Jesus, of Isa, son of Maryam, son of Mary. I am but a slave, so call me Allah's slave and his messenger. طيب. Wallahi, this is very important, brothers and sisters. This is very important. Maybe many Muslims don't know this hadith. Subhanallah. Hadith Umar al-Khattab, and this hadith, authentic hadith. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, لا تطروني. What is the meaning of لا تطروني? الإطراء is a kind of غلو. Okay, what is the meaning of غلو? غلو means to exceed the limit. Okay, this is general. إطراء is part of غلو. الغلو, when you exceed the limit in praising someone. هو الإطراء هو الغلو في المدح. To exceed your limit in praising someone. Okay, yeah, for example, you are my friend. Wallahi, you are the best friend. Never there will be a friend like you. If anyone meets you, definitely he will love you. And yeah, everyone likes to be your friend. That's subhanAllah. This is haram. This is haram. Subhanallah, to exceed the limit in praising someone. You are like angels. You are sinless, and astaghfirullah, you don't know my sins. Okay, so itra means to exceed the limit in praising someone. So the Prophet ﷺ said, don't do with me like the Christians with the Isa alayhi salatu wasalam. They considered Isa as the son of Allah. They considered Isa as Allah. They considered Isa as one out of three. The Trinity, the Aqidah al-Tathlith. Wal-Iyadu Billah. Shirk. No. I am the slave of Allah and also I am the messenger of Allah. إِنَّمَا أَنَا عَبْدٌ فَقُولُوا عَبْدُ اللَّهِ وَرَسُولُهُ. Okay, brothers, sisters, I like to stop here. جزاكم الله خير. This is wallahi very important. Please, brothers, sisters, يعني if you have شرح الشيخ بن عثيمين, this is a very great شرح. Explanation, it is translated in two volumes. Okay, read this chapter, read the whole book, wallahi. Okay, now if you have a question, please, brothers, sisters. Any question, brothers, sisters? حياك الله وياك نديم برادر أنور حياكم الله عفوا وياك وإياك أبو عبد الله حياك الله سيد مبين دينيسيا. Any question, brothers, sisters? شيخ سلمان وإياكم وإياكم. Okay. Zala khair, one of the brothers is taking care of the website. Or yes, the website, and another brother take care of the YouTube, because yani subhanallah, it is also very important to put good titles for the lectures to make them easy to reach to them. Okay, yani you know, many times I speak about the marketing and advertising for the website. طيب. Sheikh, when will we have the next Q&A session? Good question, Tanweer, but I don't know, wallahi. I don't know. Yes, Brother Muhammad Raib told me there are many questions. I don't know. What is the name of the book you are using? I'm reading from Kitab Tauhid, the translation. This is translation. Dar Salaam. Without sharh, this is only the translation. This is the translation of Kitab Tawheed. You'll find the Arabic and English ayat. Okay, but from where the sharh, there, alhamdulillah, there are many books. And this is Abdullah Al-Qsayr and Bughyat Al-Mustafid, Mansur Al-Sag'ub. But many of them take from Sheikh Ibn Uthaymeen, rahimahullah. Also Falih Sghayr. Many, there are many sharh. Many sharh. Is it important to follow only specific scholars? These days people finding difficulties to differentiate between authentic scholars. Please advise. Brothers, sisters, we follow manhaj as-salaf. We follow manhaj as-salaf. Okay, when we say manhaj as-salaf, it means it is a way. It doesn't mean there are certain people that we have to follow them. If you are talking about people, there is only one person that we have to follow. Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam. We have to follow the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam. But you tell me that there is a person that we have follow him? No. We don't have anyone except the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. But we have the manhaj, we have the methodology, the way of the Salaf. This is the only way that the Muslims should follow. As I mentioned many times, that the way of the Salaf is not something optional. Wallahi, no, I like manhaj al-salaf, but I will not follow. No, no, no. The option is not up to you. You have to follow manhaj al-salaf. It means you have to follow manhaj al-sahaba, the way of the companions, radiyallahu ta'ala anhum. And as I mentioned before, I know sometimes you go to some websites, okay, they put you for you names. Okay, these are the good scholars, these are the bad scholars. Okay. Yes, if you like to name, yes, alhamdulillah, we have our great scholars, Imam Ahmad, Imam Malik, Ibn Taymiyyah, Ibn al-Qayyim, Alhamdulillah, Ibn al-Wahhab. Yes, we have great scholars. But to say, wallahi, there are certain scholars that we have to follow them and we imitate them 100%? No, because you will not find anyone sinless and you will not find anyone all the time he's correct. But as a way, as a path, yes, the path, or the way of Imam Ahmad, the way of Ibn Taymiyyah, the way of Ibn Baz, the way of Ibn Uthaymeen, the way is the correct way. But as a person, all of his opinions are correct? No. We cannot say, because if I say all the opinions of Sheikh Ibn Baz are correct, then I claim that Sheikh Ibn Baz is a prophet. Astaghfirullah. But no doubt, he's a great scholar. He's one of the great scholars. And we have to follow his way. Also, the same thing, Sheikh Al-Albani, rahimahullah ta'ala. But, okay, brother, sister, you know that from some points that this is a good scholars or a good scholar, they are good scholars or not. As I mentioned, the Salaf scholars, they speak about the Tauhid. Their main subject is the Tauhid. And also they speak about the Shirk. They clarify what is the meaning of Shirk and the details of Shirk. Why? Because they want to keep people away from Shirk. But if there is a da'iyah, all the time talk about the stories. Okay, wallah, there is a story and this and this. And you'll find some da'iyah, they love their followers. They love how to make followers only. Their main aim is followers and money. Okay? And of course, no need to name them. And also, please, brothers, I don't mean that if there is a da'iyah who has many followers, it means he's a wrong da'iyah. I don't mean that. Okay, but I mean, generally speaking, there is a scholar, like our mashayikh, Sheikh Ibn Uthaymeen, Sheikh Ibn Baz, mashallah, you'll find them. For example, Sheikh Ibn Uthaymeen, his books in Tawheed, Fiqh, Nahu, grammar, Arabic grammar, tafsir, akhlaq. He speaks about everything. This is like the way of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So, you can know the way, you can know the good scholar from his way. And also he's speaking polite. He's not talk about, wallahi, subhanAllah, just today I was watching one video, then you see the next. One sheikh, UK. He said, the scholars are wrong. Those scholars who are saying it is not allowed for demonstration, they are wrong. Astaghfirullah al-Azim. Habibi, are you crazy? What you are saying? The scholars of the Salaf said the demonstration is not the way of the Prophet ﷺ, this is not the correct way. You go out and you shout and subhanallah. And many times we spoke about this. Okay, in the Arab world. You remember before 9 years, 2000, at the end of, 2010 or at the beginning of 2011. Everyone can check now what did happen in some of the countries. Syria, Egypt, Tunisia, and Libya, and subhanallah. At the beginning, they went against their rulers. Okay, I'm not saying that the rulers are okay, Muslims, muwahid, like the companions. Okay, they went against the rulers. They did demonstrations. And many da'iyah, this is good. Yes, you should defend your freedom. This is jihad. And if you die, you are shaheed. Okay, then after that, after 1 year or 2 years. Okay, subhanallah. So, what is the way of the Salaf? Okay, this is known. Go and read the books of the scholars of the Salaf and you know the Haqq. And please, brothers, sisters, Sometimes we are confused. Why? Because of lack of knowledge. We should read like these books. I mean, Kitab Tauhid, Aqid al Wasatiyya. Okay, يعني أصول السنة الإمام أحمد اللالكائي. Okay, يعني there are books teach you the manhaj, the way. This is very important. You will not be confused. But for example, you read Riyad al-Salihin, you read Rahiq al-Makhtum, the Sin Nektar, you read something in Tafsir, and you don't know the manhaj, of course you will be confused. Wallahi, this is a good Sheikh. Why he's a good Sheikh? He speaks in a nice way. His English, mashallah, very nice. No, this is not the thing to decide this is good Sheikh or not. Do we have the Shar in English? Shar bin Uthaymeen, yes, it is in English. Brother Salman. Al-Qawl al-Mufid ala Kitab Tawheed, it is translated in two volumes in Dar al-Salam. Sheikh, I am concerned about the death penalty. You mentioned four, three situations at the beginning. Why? Commentary on Kitab Tawheed by Sheikh Uthaymeen, yes. Two volumes. Jazakallah khairan. That is a very clear response. When I tell people to follow the correct manhaj, I was told all the scholars are calling towards haq. Only why need to differentiate? No. Not all the scholars are calling to haq. Not all of them. So, some of them call to worship the graves. Some of them call for bid'ah. Not all the scholars. Sorry, this is not right. There are some scholars, they call to follow manhaj al-haq, follow tawheed, and to avoid shirk. But some scholars, they call Allah unity and love, peace. This is, of course, no problem, no doubt. This is very good, love and peace. Okay, but what is more important, tawheed. What is more important, tawheed. Sheikh, does that mean all demonstrations are wrong? We'll not finish about demonstration. We mentioned manhaj salaf, okay, going against the rulers, and we go on the streets. This is wrong. الاعتصامات والمظاهرات, or some people stop working to show their anger. This is not right. SubhanAllah, this is their ignorance.